everybody, Dr. Tommy Rhee here, and today we're going to talk about, for those of you that really understand or use a thing that has a VO2 max or a HRV monitor, and you're trying to improve function and fitness, and what's really important, the longevity of your active lifespan, right? So the big thing we're trying to achieve is that zone 5, that exercise, and have that sustained in a period of time of 3 minutes, right? So what that means is that we want to get to zone 5. Zone 5, if you want to really understand that, is you take your maximum heart rate, and probably the question you want to ask is, what's a maximum heart rate? Well, you take a number like 220 minus your age, and that's the number you want to get to. So that's going to be your maximum heart rate. You want to hold that for 3 minutes. Once you get to that activity level of 3 minutes, that could be from a sprint, a hard bike ride, something very aggressive, but your wearable device will get you that ability to see that heart rate to get that maximum number. Once you're at that number, you obtain that, and then the best thing about that is that that zone 5 is important, but what's really more important is the recovery. You want to think about, how do you get back down to zone 1, or really important, the resting heart rate? Well, the fastest way to do that without compromising tissue is power play. Power play does two big components of this. So we're looking at the VO2 max, and another thing is the HRV, heart rate variability, right? So those two numbers are gonna indicate our fitness level, and really what more important is how we're gonna elongate ourselves in the future. Now, what we're trying to achieve with that recovery period with power play is, number one, we're trying to get that zone 1 and get ourselves not compromising tissue, but get the nutrients back into our system and get the metabolic waste out of our system. How do we obtain that? We have to open the vessels. When we open the vessels, we have to utilize a thing called nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is produced by power plate. When you stand on power plate and do some isometric movement, power plate will give that ability to open up the vessels, so you get that nutrients to the system but get the metabolic waste out. Your recovery time shortens, number one. Then number two is the real important thing, the HRV, heart rate variability. So that's where the sympathetic and the parasympathetic nervous system activates. We want parasympathetic. We want the vasodilation, the relaxation, the recovery. How do we do that? Well, there's a vasal tone. There is a vagal tone that we have to achieve with power play. The neat thing about that is that it gives the ability to relax, parasympathetic. Your recovery time speeds up. Now, in fitness, we look at numbers like from zone 5 to resting heart rate and the time. If we can reduce that time, you recover faster, your fitness level goes up. Power play helps us with that. My recommendation, you want to go with 30 hertz, 10 minutes. That's how you recover. So when you get to zone 5 and you push yourself hard, think about those two things. We want to recover fast, and we want to get that junk, that metabolic waste, and get ourselves back to resting heart rate. Power play does that. 10 minutes, 30 hertz. Okay guys, thanks a lot.